Hello everyone, welcome to New Wave Coaching Classroom Mathematics. This is your host Jatin. Today we are going to continue our exercise 13.3, which is based on conversion of solids from one form to the another form. And we will be starting with question number 7, and today we are going to complete this exercise, remaining 3 questions of this exercise. So let's start with question number 7. In question number 7, it is given a cylindrical bucket 32 cm high and with radius of base as 18 cm is filled with sand. The bucket is emptied on the ground and a conical heap of sand is formed. If the height of the conical heap is 24 cm, find the radius and slant height of the heap. Now, let's draw the diagram first. Now, what is given? We have a cylindrical bucket, right? And the dimension is given as 32 cm and a base radius of 18 cm. So this is given to us. The base radius is 18 cm and the height is given as 32 cm. Right. So let's write first thing what is given. So we write height of cylindrical bucket. We take A as capital H, this is equal to 32 cm, and the radius of cylindrical bucket this R is given as 18 cm. Now let's do first thing, let's find out the volume of sand inside this cylindrical bucket. So we have volume of sand inside the bucket. Now since it is a cylindrical, so the formula will be pi r square h. So we write the formula pi r square h. So that is equal to pi into 18 square into 32 centimeter cube. I'm leaving it here because this is not the final answer, so we need not to find out what the value of this is. Now, whatever the sand is filled in this cylindrical bucket, that is taken out and a conical heap will form, something like this. Now, this conical heap, the height is given as 24 cm. Height of 24 cm, h is equal to 24 cm. Now what we have to find the radius and the slant height. So we suppose let radius of conical heap equal to r cm and slant height of conical heap is equal to l cm. Right. Now we know whatever is the volume of sand is there inside the cylindrical tank, the volume of the cone is also same, there is no difference. So we write since volume does not change, therefore volume of conical heap is equal to volume of the cylindrical bucket. So write it as volume of cylindrical bucket. Right. So with the substitute value, now since it's a cone, so the formula would be 1 by 3 pi r square h. So this is 1 upon 3 pi r square h is equal to, and here we have pi r square h. We can also substitute the value, whatever we have found, or we can just write the formula also. This doesn't matter actually. We just cancel out pi. We need to find r. So we write r square is equal to, this 3 will get multiplied up. So this will be 3 r square h. And the denominator we have small h. Now we substitute the values. If this is 3 multiplied by 18 multiplied by 18 multiplied by the capital H. Capital H is given to us as 32 centimeters. And the whole is divided by small h, that is given as 24 centimeters. Now we just cancel out. This cancels out. This is 8. This cancels out with this. This is 4. Now, what do you get? R square is equal to 18 multiplied by 18 into multiplied by 4. Now, there are two ways to simplify this this thing. Either we multiply complete thing and then we find the square root. This is the one way. Most of the students do this way. But that is a basically a lengthy way. Since you have to find the square root, so instead of multiplying, we can directly find the square root. How? As you learned in your grade 8. How? Now, I can write r is equal to square root of 18 multiplied by 18 multiplied by 4. I write this thing. Now, when we find the square root using the prime factorization method, what we do? We make the prime factors of whatever the number is inside the root. So, already I have a pair of 18. What I can do? I can make this 4 as, I can write this 4 as, this way. So I have one pair from here, one from here. So I get r equals to 18 multiplied by 2, that is equal to 36 centimeters. So this is what I get, the radius. Now I need to find the slant height also. So l will be equal to h square plus r square. So substitute the values. H is given to me as h was 24. So I write 24 whole square. Plus r is 36, so this is 36 whole square. Making the square of both, this is 576 plus 1296. Now when we add these two, we get the value as 1876. So 6 plus 6 is 12. 2, 1 carry. 16 plus 1, 17. 1 carry again. 5 plus 2, 7 plus 1, 8. And then we have this 1872. Now let's find out the square root of this using prime factorization method. So this is the prime factorization method by which we can find the square root of 1872. We just go by 2 and I get 936. Again I go by 2, I get here as 4, then I get 6, then I get 8. Again by 2, this is 234. This is 117. Again, now by 3. And finally, now it means the prime factors of 1872 will be something like this. 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2. So we have 2 4 times. And then we have 3 2 times. And then we have 13. So we make the pairs. This is 1, 2, 3 pairs. So one number from each pair comes out. This is 2. Multiplied by 2, multiplied by 3, and multiplied by the 13 doesn't have a pair, so it remains inside the root. And I get the value L as 12 into square root of 13 centimeter. So this is the solution of question number 7. Let's go to the next question, that is question number 8. Now let's see question number 8. Is given, water in a canal 6 meter wide and 1.5 meter deep is flowing with a speed of 10 km per hour. How much area will it irrigate in 30 minutes if 8 cm of standing water is needed? Now, I have made a canal, a cross section of a canal, and this canal is basically, it is given that this is 1.5 meter deep, so this is 1.5 meter, and this thing, that is this thing is given to me as 6 meter, that is the width of the canal. Now, the water from this is used to irrigate a field, right? And obviously in the field the water required, standing water required, the height should be 8 cm. The speed of the water that is moving is 10 km per hour. Now we need to find in 30 minutes how much area can we irrigate of the field, right? So how we have to do, first of all we'll find the volume of water which is flowing through the canal in 1 hour, right? And then we'll find in 30 minutes how much water will be there, and obviously the volume will remain same, and using the height of the standing water we can find the area irrigated. So let's see it now. Now here this height, this is 8 cm, right? So first of all, width of the canal we take it as capital B here, because it is in shape of a cuboid, so capital LBH and small LBH we have to use, so that is 6 meters. And depth of the canal this is 1.5 meter. Now the speed of water this is given as 10 kilometer per hour, and that is equal to 10,000 meters per hour, right? This is what we have. Now the next thing we will find is the volume of water flowing in 1 hour. Now since the shape of the water, or the from the thing where the water is coming out, is a shape of a cuboid, so we'll take the formula of the volume of cuboid, that is length multiplied by breadth multiplied by height. Now you must be thinking, but we are going to take the length, so length will be this 10,000 meters per hour, because in 1 hour the length of amount 10,000 meters of the length of the water is moving forward, so that is why we are taking the length as 10,000. So this is 10,000 multiplied by 6 into 1.5. Now we multiply all these things. So after multiplying, we get this thing as 90,000 meter cube. So this is the volume of water moving in 1 hour. But what we require is the volume of water in 30 minutes. That is half of this. Right? So obviously in 30 minutes it would be half of this, and half of this would be 45,000. Meter cube, right? This is the volume of water which basically will be irrigating the field in 30 minutes. Now, next thing, the height of standing water required here so I take small f because I already have taken capital F, so that is 8 cm. Now converting into meters, that is 0.8 meters. Now since the volume remains same, therefore the volume of standing water, volume of water in the field is basically equal to volume of water moving from the canal in 30 minutes. So volume of water moving in 30 minutes. Now we know the formula of volume is basically area into the length of whatever the object is there. Here we write it as area multiplied by height is equal to, now what is the volume of water moving in 30 minutes is 45,000 meter cube. So we write this equal to 45,000. Therefore area to be irrigated is equal to 45,000 and you divide by height, that is 0.08, and after simplifying we get it as 562500 meters square. We can also convert this into hectares. 1 hectare is equal to 10,000 meter square. So this becomes 56.25 hectares. Right, so this is the solution of question number 8. Now let's see the last question of this exercise, that is question number 9. Is given, a farmer connects a pipe of internal diameter 20 cm from a canal into a cylindrical tank in her field, which is 10 meter in diameter and 2 meter deep. If water flows through the pipe at the rate of 3 km per hour, how much time will the tank be filled? So what we have to find in this question, as we have seen in the previous question, the speed was given and we found actually the area irrigated. But in this question, we have to find in how much time the tank is filled. Question is almost same. Let's understand it. I have already done the solution. So this is basically the pipe which is connected with the canal from which water is coming and going inside the cylindrical tank. Now, the diameter of this cylindrical pipe is 20 cm. And the speed of water which is coming from this is 3 km per hour. Now, this cylindrical tank dimension, the diameter is given as 10 meters and the height is given as 2 meters. Right? Now, let's see. Diameter of pipe is 20 cm, so radius becomes 10 cm. We are converting everything into meters. So, 10 cm makes 0.1 meter after dividing by 100. Then, speed of water is 3 km per hour. That means 3000 meters per hour. It means the water moves 3000 meters in 1 hour. Now, first of all, we find the volume of water flowing in 1 hour. Now, since the water is flowing through the cylindrical pipe, so obviously the volume will be, the formula we will be using will be the formula of the volume of the cylinder. So that is pi r square h. The r is basically the radius of the pipe and the h is the this thing. I have not mentioned here, so we will be taking this thing as h. H equal to 3000 meters per hour. Now, pi r square h, so pi multiplied by 0.1 whole square and h is 3000 meters, right? Now, whenever we square any number, the number of decimal places increases. On squaring the number of decimal places doubles basically. If the number has one decimal place, the square will have two decimal places. If the number have two decimal places, then the square will have four decimal places. So here 0.1 whole square becomes 0.01 pi into 3000. Now what, we are not substituting the value of pi. We multiply all this, we get it as 30 pi meter cube. It means in 1 hour, this much amount of water, this much volume of water is moving in 1 hour, right? Now we talk about tank which we have to fill. Now the height of the tank, h, is 2 meters. See now, I have two cylindrical things, so I have taken the different symbols for both. One small h, the other is capital H. Diameter of the tank is given as 10 meters. So obviously the radius will be half of that, that is 5 meters. Now let's find how much water can be collected in this cylindrical tank. Obviously we have to find the volume of the water inside this. So that will be equal to the volume of the cylindrical tank. And since in the cylinder, the formula again will be pi r square h. So we just substitute volume of cylindrical tank is this. We substitute the value. The r is given as 5. So this is 5 square multiplied by into h. That is 2 meters. So we get 50 pi meter cube. Now this is the total volume of the cylindrical tank. Or we can say this is the total volume of the water which can be collected in the cylindrical tank. And this is the amount of water moving in 1 hour. So if I have to find time taken to fill the tank, that will be equal to volume of tank divided by volume of water flowing in 1 hour. So we divide 50 pi by 30 pi, this one, and we get this as 5 by 3 hours. Now we can leave it here also. We can just keep it like this. This is equal to 1, 2 by 3 hours. Right? Or we can also convert it into minutes by multiplying it with 60. So when we multiply it by 60, we get the answer as 100 minutes. Right, dear friends? So this was all about the exercise in which we have studied when we convert one object into another, the volume length remains same, and how we can find the different dimensions. I hope you have understood everything. If not, just try to watch the video again. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel. So this is your host signing off. Goodbye and take care. Bye-bye.